gentlemen, I have the result of the Brent East constituency. I, the undersigned, being the acting returning officer for the Brent East constituency of the London Borough of Brent, do hereby give notice that the number of votes recorded for each candidate at the election is as follows. Crawley, Harriet Spencer,
Conservative,
15,119.
That's an increase on the Conservative vote of last time. She looks very happy about it. Her supporters certainly sound very happy about it.
Dooley, Riaz, Qureshi,
Independent Labour,
1,035. Finkelstein, Daniel William,
Alliance,
5,710.
That's less than the Alliance got last time.
Litvinov, Miles,
Green Party,
716. Livingstone, Kenneth Roberts,
Labour,
16,000.
That makes him the winner, but it is less than Labour got last time. Ken, however, doesn't look too unhappy about that. Livingstone, he has at last found a seat. He looks very happy about it indeed. But about 2,000 less than the previous Labour candidate had.
And I do hereby declare that the said Kenneth Robert Livingstone is duly elected to serve as member of Parliament.
Seat for Ken Livingstone, but a reduced majority. That's the picture here in Brent East.
I would just like to thank the returning officer and all those public officials who've worked at this account to actually ensure that it took place as quickly as we possibly managed and ensure our safety. I'd like to thank the candidates that took part in this campaign for running a campaign based on issues. It has been a tough and a difficult campaign, and I must say, after such a long time, it's a pleasure at last to get elected to Parliament. I cannot just simply end at that point. I think we have to accept tonight is a major setback for the Labour movement in this country. We have had 8 years of a government that have been, frankly, quite horrendous for the people that Labour represents. But the lesson of these last 4 weeks is that Labour can set the agenda. We have actually been able to organise a campaign throughout the country, which is undoubtedly the best that we have seen since 1964. The lesson is that it isn't enough just to run a good campaign at election times. We need to run a campaign like this year by year by year if we're to win the next election. We also need to realise that we have failed to capture the support of women in the numbers that we should. When you look at the polls, it's quite clear that women have not voted for Labour on the basis that the policies we put forward, whilst they're excellent ones, weren't put at the centre of our campaign. We have excellent policies in those areas. If we're to win the support of women in the numbers that will open the way for a future Labour government, we have to ensure that those policies come to the forefront of what we do. Finally, we have to realise that the greatest challenge to this government in the last 4 years hasn't been what has happened in Parliament. It's been the fight that has been raised in one industrial dispute after another, from the miners through Wapping. It has been the struggle. It has been the struggle of ordinary Labour councils to defend the services and jobs they're responsible for, often with not the support we should have expected from other areas of the Labour movement. And if we're to defeat this government, we make it quite clear. We will defeat this government outside Parliament. And that struggle starts tonight.